if you look at the, you look behind the headline, look at the categories where these prices are really going up, you'll see that it tends to be areas that are directly affected by the reopening. That's something that we'll go through over a period that will then be over, and it should not leave much of a mark on the ongoing inflation process.
All right, joining us now, John Malden, co-founder of Malden Economics, Forbes senior contributor, David Bahnsen, Bahnsen Group managing partners. John Malden, is Jay Powell right? He sounds very persuasive. It's only temporary. Bunch of one-off price hikes.
It makes me nervous when I agree with the Federal Reserve economist here lately, but I think he's right. We're going to have a temporary rise in inflation. We're seeing that. When we get past the easy comparisons from 12 months ago, even if wages do stay somewhat sticky, because that's really what we're talking about, because the supply chain stuff, prices are going to come back down. You're going to end up with comparisons at some point, and it'll flatten those inflationary numbers out. And the natural bent, when we're in the age of transformation, is that technology and all the other wonderful things we're doing is making things cheaper.
Dave Bahnsen, the only nit I have to pick with John is, what's wrong with higher wages? I mean, if the workforce is coming back to work after the horrible pandemic, really catastrophic shock, they're coming back to work. They're going to get off unemployment. That's happening already, and the rest of it will be done in September. What's wrong with higher wages? They're producing, productivity is going up. You know, higher wages, more people working with better wages, that's not the cause of inflation, is it, David Bahnsen?
No, the Phillips curve is dead, Larry. The problem with higher wages is only if they come because of non-market forces. If it's artificially higher wages because of interventions that have screwed up the market, then of course it cuts into corporate profits. But if wages are growing because things are organically moving in the right direction, that's a good thing. I agree with you. Phillips curve is dead.
Only thing we have to fear right now, this is from earlier in the show, gentlemen, if the filibuster is ended and the stuff that will get passed will sink stocks and drive interest rates and inflation sky high. So we've talked about filibuster. I think Jay Powell's doing a pretty good job myself. John Malden's good to see you. It's been a while. David Bahnsen.